let's take a look at five of my favorite tips using Adobe Premiere Elements. This is in version 13, but newer versions should just be the same. Tip number one, rename files to force a natural order in the timeline. For example, I'm about to create a video on how to change the oil in my car, so I've got several clips showing the supplies, the tools, wrenches, the hood latch, the process, and so on and so forth. So I don't have to sit there and figure all of this out in the timeline, just rename everything to 01, 05, 10, 15, and so on and so forth. That way, when you bring it into Adobe Premiere Elements, everything will be in a nice natural order. The reason I leave a gap between each of these things is if I forget something and want to insert something, I just simply make a 03 or a 04 or whatever. Also, notice how I actually add the name of the video in there so I have reference later on. So what that looks like is if we add the media and we go to that folder. Tip number two, how do you delete clips without closing video gaps? Maybe you found this tip, but maybe you haven't. So the classic problem is you pick a clip, you hit the delete key, and it closes that gap for you. Not necessarily the desired behavior that you always want. Trick, right click, and select delete from the right mouse button menu. Then you can move things above it, below it, or wherever you want, and you don't have to worry about that space. Now, if you really want to get rid of that gap, just right click and delete and close gap one more time. Tip number three, how do you delete audio from B-roll or P&IP videos? Let's say you want to overlay one clip on top of another one, but you have audio tracks on both of these clips. Sometimes that can be undesirable, especially if you have talking in one clip and talking in the other one. The two tend to conflict with each other. Maybe what I want is I want the video of this clip, but the audio of this clip. So how you do that? Right click, delete audio. Tip number four, how to access a graphical motion path to control special effects locations. Back to my PIP example here. Let's just say I don't want this video to cover up the whole page. I want it to be a small picture-in-picture. So there's a few ways you can do. The first tip here is just click in the graphics window and you get these cute little handles on all four corners and the center points. Just grab the corner by gingerly finding it, sizing it to wherever you want on your screen. Now you have a nice picture-in-picture. Wouldn't it be nice if I could dance this thing around and have my picture-in-picture zoom in or move around? So how you can do that is if you notice I have my video clip expanded, this cute little arrow, the far left hand side of the screen, and I get this little yellow bar here. By default, that's on the opacity setting. If I scroll my timeline up, you can see how it says opacity. If you drop this little arrow down here, you can select motion and then position. And notice I get this little white dot up here on my screen. Now wherever I click, this small keyframe on the very far right-hand side, it adds a keyframe to remember that spot. So if I move my cursor over here somewhere, then move my video, it adds this keyframe for me automatically. So watch what happens. This video very, very slowly pans itself around. I could do the same thing for zoom control if I wanted to. Process is generally the same. Go to this little drop-down list, go to motion, and go to scale. Put your cursor wherever you want. Add a keyframe to control that scale. And let's make it small here. And at the very end, we'll make it nice and big so you can see a nice drastic change. Now, I'm not suggesting this is a very good effect here, but it gives you the idea of what you can do with this small down and dirty keyframe kind of an editor. Now you're going to see it pan and scale at the same time. Again, this is very, very slow, too slow for me, but you get the idea on what you can do with this capability. And of course, you can simply drag these endpoints in if you want to speed things up. We'll go to our motion position, and we'll drag this in to speed things up just a little bit more. And it might go a little bit faster for us. Good, but not exactly what I'm looking for. Anyway, that's a down and dirty way to control things like motion position, scale, rotation, anchor point, and a few other things. You can also control the opacity by, again, adding a keyframe here. You know the process. Add this little keyframe dot thingy. We'll add another one, and now I can drag these down to have it sort of fade in very, very slowly. And of course, we can change this fade in point to give us a nice gradual fade in. A little weird there, but you get the idea. Tip number 5 in the holy grail of keyframe editing, let me show you a precise way to control the position effects of your videos. Let's go back to our PIP example here and make sure the video clip is selected. Then up on the applied effects tab, we're going to expand that. And up on the very top, you see this little stopwatch. Click that, and that brings up a very small timeline window to control the time of the video of just that clip. Now, notice these little keyframes that we put in here earlier for the position and the scale. They show up in this small editor here. The beauty with this thing is I can go to the very first keyframe. I can type in some precise numbers, like, I don't know, 800 by 250 or whatever. And then I can go to the next one and type in, I don't know, 400. I'm just making up some numbers now. And you get some very, very precise control on the size and the location of your videos. You can also drag these keyframes around to really speed things up to make your video run a little faster, or I should say your effect in your video run a little bit faster. Still really, really slow. You get the idea here. Let's select it again. And let's fence select these, drag them in much, much closer, and you're gonna see this effect happen much, much faster. Of course, my opacity here is off as well. Notice I could drag it down here if I wanted to, or I could go to the opacity, and I could change its location in this small timeline window. Well, I hope you learned something. Those are 5 tips that I use on a daily basis. Stay tuned, more tips to come. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment, and if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up.